Hello. I almost feel like I should go and make some coffee. Jesus Christ, what the fuck is that emote? So tiny. It's like scrambled. I don't know what that is. Sakura clicker emote. That's a good idea too. Or just a Sakura emote. I guess that'll just be tits, right? I'll probably do it based on like what games people normally ask me, like when are you streaming again? City Skylines, I don't know how you could do an emote for that without it just being tiny and incomprehensible. We're gonna do Shopkeep now. Yonder emote. Yeah. I made an emote for you. It is, yeah, I can't tell what's going on with that one. It's kind of hard to see. I'm sorry. Should just be a blender over some boobs. It's good. I wanted to make a shirt like that, where it's like right over like where your boobs would be. There's blenders with my faces on them, but I haven't got around to making that yet. Why are we dropping frames? It's almost like AT&T is throttling me again, which is ultra fun. I wish they wouldn't. Anyway, we're doing Shopkeep now. I should probably change the ticker to represent that. There we go. There we go. All right, cool. We're doing pretty good on this save. We just got the ability to do weed and sell to wizards. Because, I don't know how you would wear a shirt like that. Like, not even where, like, the faces are centered to your chest, like you would expect, but they're, like, off-center. I don't know. We don't have a whole lot of extra money going around right now. We do need to make sure we have the stuff for them. They want wizard staves. In fact, druids want them as well, but we can't sell the druids just yet. Now, how do we get a wizard staff? Well, we scroll down and we go fuck ourselves because we don't have availability to that. We should probably get some other people available, and then that way we can kind of diversify our market, I guess. I don't know. Some of these things might be good as well. I'm not too concerned about a lot of it, though. This situation, if I can figure out how to do it, would be good, but the markup when you're talking to people straight to their face, people tend to buy a second thing after they purchase the first thing. Entry fee. Those would all be good, but I think
Stay underground,
it would
young
be nice
man.
to be able to jump so I could jump over countertops, but whatever. Whatever, game. Let's go burrow in the trash like a fucking raccoon again. I could make a check the weed shirt. 69 appeal. Yes, it's because I killed a couple people, and I think there might be a dead body laying around still. No, there's nothing in the trash. I still don't feel like I'm totally awake. I might have to go make
No.
coffee. No. May have to make coffee in a minute. I've had this meat just sitting out here for like days. It's just here. And Nintendo wants me to know that. Save 30% off games right now. So that's great. Thanks, Nintendo. I wish I could remember how to turn off the ads. You want nothing? You'll get nothing. You should eat an awake bar. I don't know what the fuck that is. Hey, would it not be weird if I asked, a mod to time me. Why would you want to be timed out? I don't get. Some people have some weird stuff going on where they want to be punished. It's a little bit kinky. I mean, so, yeah. You know what? I think I may make I'm gonna make some coffee real quick. You wanna listen to me make coffee? It'll sound like this. Online punishment isn't fun. Some people get into it. Like, they have that as a kink. I don't know. Whatever floats your boat, man. You got a band kink where you wanna be banned? Sub to me and I'll ban you. Come into my shop and buy my shit. I use the finest of regular store-bought beans to, Oh shit, there's somebody- Oh, you fucking asshole! Thought you could get away while I was trying to make coffee? Fuck you, asshole! Bam! Fuck you. Asshole.
Good day.
Trying to make coffee? Fuck! Let's go clean up the dead guy outside. Oh. Alright, well. There's also, like, the Rev-gasm face that people wanted. People wanted that shit, too. Sift through the trash while we wait for, Rev and GPM cream team. We'd have to do it a few more times for it to be a thing. I don't meme well. I don't meme enough. I need to meme more. I'm very quiet. The music's very loud. Okay, hold on. Let me turn down the volume. Your mic is way low. It's probably because I'm not close enough to it. How is that now? Let me try and boost it to 100%. Music is just taking off like it's a fucking rocket. There we go. How's that? We're selling a lot of stuff, but we need to get back in there. Selling weed? We're doing well? what's a hot item? What do we need? We need wizard wands? Wait, no, it's changed. They want wizard hats now. Holy shit. Alright. Alright, can we sell wizard hats? Is that a thing we have? Wizard hats. No? No, we can't make wizard hats. We can make wizard gloves. Y'all want that shit? And we need more weed. Straight up need more weed. Oh, that's a little bit too much weed. I know, I know. You should sell coffee ASMR. ASMR. That makes me happy. Did I need to do that? No. But you know what? It made me happy. Do I have the ability to put up hat racks? Hey, come into my shop. Aurora Brinley, the mage. Well, I got a plenty of weed. Come back for any weed. Anytime. She had a... Oh, it's a shield that I sold her. Have the frame issues been improved? It's been better since I got a better computer. You need an upper-end computer to stream this game, which does not look like it needs an upper-end computer. It's kind of sad. But I think some of the more recent fixes have helped to kind of stop that a bit, but not as much as needed. Now we watch the weed grow. We need more weed, though. Is Rev Tilda? No. Tilda is my girlfriend. I should probably get a security bot, because I mean, like, selling weed is pretty hardcore business, man. Wizards love weed. That's what it's about, man. Like, look, we're gonna put some premium weed out. See, this is good shit. It's not like the... Did you just throw that on the floor? Who threw this? Who put this on the floor? Swear to God, if you come in here and you start throwing shit around on the floor, I'll fucking kill you. Anyway. That's the premium weed right there. It's better. It's higher class. It's in a black box with gold lettering. It's very fancy. It's not. It's not any different, but the packaging is different, so you think it's better. Anyway, look at this shit. Thank you. See? You look at that shit, and you're like, man, yeah, I do need that. I do need that shit. And I'm like, yeah, I know, bitch. I know. And see this guy? He just got a sword. And that sword will allow us to buy... Well, how much is a bookshelf's worth? 3x4, that's 12, so 12... Oops. Oh, we can't buy 12 weed yet. We need to wait. We need to sell some weed. You are what you eat. I don't think I am an asshole then. This thing will never sell. It's too fancy. These people are scrubs. They're like level 1 warriors and shit, you know? Like, they'll never buy anything as nice as this. I'll take it for later. Like, eventually they'll be able to buy it. But not just yet. Who throws away a perfectly good gold-plated helmet? I mean, some sort of asshole who would come in here and throw my shit on the floor? That kind of person. There's a metal belt here. I don't know if that's what your deal is. Oh, you're a mage, so you probably don't want that. But you do want that health potion. And thank you for coming to my shop and buying that. Do I have this? I don't have enough skill points for that yet. But I do think I'll buy some weed. If I bring it down... Oh, two people are coming to the shop. They're both going for the weed. Are they going to go for the same weed? Cause if, oh, you asshole! Yeah, you shouldn't have done that. Fuck you. You can't steal my weed, bitch. And then the other guy left because he was like, oh, this is about to go down. This is about to go down hard. And then I look like an asshole for killing someone who's robbing me. Fuck you. Excuse me, ma'am. Just cleaning up a dead body. Thank you. I don't know why people think they can get away with stealing from me. It's not a terribly great track record for anyone. Like, anyone who's ever attempted to steal from me has died. It's a fairly common trend. It's like a 1-to-1 ratio, people who tried to steal from me and people who die. You know, maybe you shouldn't do that shit. This is all upper-end shit that I've gotten out of the trash that no one wants to buy. The wild growth potion might be good now. I mean, I don't know. Maybe wizards want that shit. Take it. It's not that I vaporized them with a broom. It's that I clean up with the broom. So, hey. Wow. Look at you. Look at you not going into my shop. Let's talk about that. You want nothing? Let me check your equipment. You have nothing. Because you're a fucking scrub. Get out of my house. Get out of my way. Someone came into my shop, bought weed, and then threw it in the trash. These plebs do not know about good weed. You know what? That weed, it's going on the premium shelf. That's what you do. You get some damaged weed, right? It's going down here. You get some damaged weed, you call it artisanal, you know? Or you call it, organic. Organic weed, right? People are like, oh, it looks funny because it's organic. That's why. People are dumb, they'll buy it. Anyway, let's just make sure no one steals. This guy. I'm warning you. Yeah. That's right, bitch. Locally sourced. Earth blessed. He came and got a priest to come and bless our weed. Organic, dank, artisanal weed. And you can't say it's just artisan. You have to say artisanal. The fuck is artisanal? Is that even a word? I love that you can hear the weed grow if you listen. Hippies will buy anything. Saw this, it's like a video about these people, and they basically were selling just like McDonald's hamburgers to people, but they were saying that they were like upper end stuff. And the people were like, yeah, this is the best. Like, you know, this isn't like your normal cheap McDonald's shit. This is good. It's hilarious. Gluten-free weed. Is weed gluten-free? Can you claim weed is gluten-free? I don't know what gluten is, to be honest. Like, what gluten stuff has. It's mostly like bread and stuff, but then like... Yeah. GMO-free weed. Like, I didn't add GMOs to the weed that I got in the trash. It's fine. I haven't been able to do, shopkeep in so long. There's already no gluten in weed. Cool, so we can say it's gluten-free weed. Awesome. What the hell is gluten? It's, I think it's a complex sugar or something? It's a type of... thing. I don't know. And, some people have a gluten intolerance. They're basically racist towards gluten. I think that's how it works. I don't know. This is one of those subjects that I don't know what I'm talking about, so I'm just gonna make shit up. It's a starch. There you go. They're racist towards starches, and so they want to separate out their starches. You got the starch that you put on your clothes, you got the starch that goes in your bread. They can't mix. Helter skelter. But with starch. Everyone run home before you get cold. I think gluten intolerance actually is a thing. Like, it has something to do with something. I'm making fun of it, but it is actually a thing, I think. Did I sell the wild growth potion? Did I put that out? I think I did, and it sold. Yeah, I think that sold. Do I have enough skills to be able to do the thing? No, I don't. It's called celiac disease, yes. There you go. I'm making fun of an entire group of people who have an actual condition. I don't know if you guys know this. Might want to check into it, but... get this. I'm a douchebag. Can we get the Skyrim helmets yet? Don't think so. No, so we can't sell that one. Arrows? Can't sell arrows yet. We don't have that as an option. I'm gonna go get some, coffee real quick. Can you not eat shrooms? Yeah, I've actually known people who have, gluten problems. I hung out with a person with gluten problems last night. So I don't know why I'm being a dick right now. It's because I'm an asshole. I explained this earlier. Anyway, back to this. Am I gonna play this enough to get raided? I don't know. I'm gonna get Frost... see, I don't know if I can actually complete any of these. I'd like to get the thing where they pay me anytime they walk over, but I don't think I can do that. I think I can get the, okay, yeah, we're gonna get this. We're gonna start selling stuff. I'm gonna get 10,000 for, yeah, 10,000 for that shit. No, fuck you. This? What is this? No, I'm not gonna pay 10,000 for that. And then I don't have enough money for that. And then I can get this. I mean, I think everyone's a little bit of an asshole. I think it's kind of hard to not be an asshole. Isn't it? It's hard for me not to be an asshole. Maybe I shouldn't say that it's hard to be an asshole. Maybe it's just a personal problem. Maybe I personally am just an asshole, and that is a individual issue that I have to deal with. I don't know. We're gonna buy one frost resist potion. Actually, I'm gonna check and see if I don't already have one. Hey, Cinnapepper. I actually already have one. Let me see if that sells first, rather than buying some more. And then if it does sell, then we'll get more. But in the meantime, let's go and buy 5 health potions. They're good. There we go. Okay, let's open the door. Let's get on to this shit. Rev, you're a soft boy. Oh. Oh wow, dropping a lot of frames. Not sure what's happening, but it's happening. I put way too much milk in my coffee. And I think the milk may have gone off, but, you know. There's a certain amount of me that's too lazy to actually give a fuck. You would shop at my keep? Oh. Is that gasoline? Oh, it's for, the bots. The bots need gasoline. Do they take tax out? I think there is a tax they take out, but I don't know. Honestly, don't know how it works. I still need to buy tickets, like plane tickets, to Pennsylvania for too many games. I still haven't done that. I'm a little nervous about it. Yeah, it would be nice if it was like the Twitch integration that what was the name of that game? The one where you climb down a building. I forget the name of. It was an okay game. I liked it for a while, but then I realized how shallow of a game it was. Anyway, it had Twitch integration, which was awful, but what it allowed to happen was that it would name, like, enemies in the game. That the frame rate is just awful, and I can't explain it. Yeah, there you go. I am a good person. See, I say that. But yeah, it would be nice if the, like, you know, like, if I could do Twitch integration, it would just name people who walked in. It wasn't Choice Chamber. It was another game that didn't do the, yeah, I think it was Skyfall. That game was okay, but it's just so one-dimensional. Even if it just used y'all's names, it would be great. Weed sells for a fuck ton. Skyfall I enjoyed, but not enough to, like, keep playing it. Yeah, no. Getting a better computer was what helped my frame rate problem. We're selling almost exclusively weed right now. Kind of a roguelite. Enchanted robe? You don't even have the money for that shit. What are you talking about? Yeah, see, that would be great if, like, you know, oh shit, you know, Sleazles is running off with my shit and I gotta go kill him. Like, that's hilarious to me. That would be cool. They should do that. I should recommend that to him. May not be the right time of year for frost potions. Well, I don't have to sell in an alleyway like some, like, bootleg-ass motherfucker. Like, I am a legit salesman. Oh, buy the frost potion. Oh. Alright, well, shit. I'm gonna buy more weed. I'm gonna put this fuel can up, too, because we don't have a robot, so it's just kind of here. There we go. Do I have enough to do the when they walk in? No, not yet. Almost, though. Once that gets around, we can get this ability. No, wait. Oh, fuck, it's 55. Come on. Go buy my shit. Buy the frost potion. Just proof of concept, buy. Order's ready in the back room. Don't steal anything. If you do, I'll find you and I'll kill you and your family. Just, no. Yeah, that's what I thought. That's what I thought. This is a legal operation, yes. Like, I mean, basically, there is no law in this town, as far as I can tell. Like, people are just expected to just kill people who come and steal. Go check in the shop real quick. And, like, zap people from all the way over here. Just watch the weed as it grows. Exciting stuff. Alright. We got our weed, we got our artisanal weed, we got our regular weed, we got our discount weed, we got our frost potions, which we're hoping will sell, but honestly, at this rate, it looks like they're not gonna. I mean, with no law in this town, I pretty much make the rules. Like, people have to buy weapons from me. What was that? What just happened? I think just something fell through the world there. Okay, well, good. It was big and green. I think it didn't get quite out of the trash container, and I couldn't pick it up before it fell, so. Oh well. Okay, nothing in the trash. Let's get back before anyone tries to steal anything. Hold my sword out just in case if anyone starts bolting. I vomited? It's Oscar the Grouch. It's also a possibility. Oh, we need to fix shit. It's all broken and shit. I don't think this costs me anything. It's just another chore that you need to do in order to keep the show running. I mean, the hat rack should not be damaged at all because there's absolutely nothing on it, nor has there been anything on it. Should probably get more swords and shit, but I pretty much have to sell some of this stuff first. Come and buy some of my artisanal weed. Like, most of these people don't even have weapons. I could kill all of them. There's nothing stopping me other than my own reputation being damaged. See, everyone walked out with something that made them happy, and that's what it's about, man. Walking out with shit that makes you happy. Capitalism is what it's about. Trash cans in medieval times? It was a recent addition to the game. Should probably buy some swords. Steal and I kill you. If we get one more sale, then we can buy another sword. Can you speak German? No. Is no German in German? Or is no in German? There's a lot of languages. No, it's nine, right? Fuck. Fuck off. Not having that. You don't have to keep permitting him. Like, just permit him when necessary. If he asks. I mean, yeah, I'll straight up kill you. It makes me really, like, hated by people. But, I mean, honestly, what am I supposed to do? Feathers of Rav hat? No one's gonna buy that. But you know what? Whatever. Remember that, shirt design? I'll probably just hire someone like Volcanic Fires or Brototop to do it. I did some voice acting work for Brototop. It was the first time I ever did like voice acting outside of something that I was doing for myself, so I can buy swords now. Can I buy another one? I can buy two. And two potions. Feathers of Rev Hat here. Come and buy it. What the fuck? How about what the fuck you for knocking shit off my shelves? Fuck you, bitch. No, I shouldn't. Might have to get someone else to design it just because I don't have the extra time. And like, drawing blenders is kind of hard. And I don't want to just, like, take an image of a blender online. You know what I mean? Also, something to do with weed, but I want it to be a little bit classier. You know? When do you outsource your labor to the third world? I don't know. I do need to outsource, my art website stuff. So, for the next little bit, I would recommend not buying anything from my art website. I know that's a weird thing for me to say, but, the company that I've been getting prints from has gone downhill, and they also have started to charge more. So in order to get good stuff, I have to pay a little bit more, which means that I'm not really making that much of a profit. So, I'm just gonna, rather than deal with that, I'm just gonna, convert over to, like, Redbubble or something. I don't know, I haven't quite figured out what I'm going to do. It also means that I wouldn't have to keep buying a post office box. The girl at the post office, like, was a total bitch to me when I came in. I was just like, yeah, I want to close out the post box. She's like, oh, well, fill out this form. Oh, do you want me to put your address, or... someone else's address. Like, you know, do you want me to put my address here, or do you want me to put my, like, apartment? She's like, ah, millennials. It's like, okay, bitch. We can play this game. You know? Like, older generations not showing any goddamn respect for us younger generations. What the fuck? Teesprings are not really struggling. They're fine. There's a company that, Screenwave would prefer me going with, and I think it's just because we end up making more profit. How old was she? She was like 50? Yeah, and that's what was weird. It was like, I'll literally fill out this form, but I've never filled out this form before. Like, just tell me what you mean by address. Do you mean the address of where we are now, or do you mean the address of, what is a millennial? If you are under the age of 12, or if you're older than, I think it's 13, but we're born after 1989, or 1987, something like that, 1988, I'm on the cusp of not being a millennial. But I'm hip and cool with the kids. Yeah, no one thinks I'm young. That's not a problem I have. People always think I'm old. Do I have enough to make it so that way I can get that one upgrade? It's not the one I want, but I mean, this entire chain would not be bad to start investing in, but this would be helpful. Getting these eventually would be good, but it's so hard to get extra points. Born in, like, the late 80s, early 90s. Yeah. Somewhere in that region. Most of the people who watch my stuff are in that range. Though there are a few people who are a bit older. I don't know. It's if you're born from 1980 to 2000. Okay. I think if you were able to enjoy media in the 2000s, I think that makes you a, millennial. Like, if you were born in, like, I think as late as 2010, you stopped counting as a millennial. I don't know. Someone should check it. But it was just so weird to just, like, have someone be that hostile towards me. It's like, we're just on this journey of life together, and, you know, we all go through our own challenges, and your challenge is about to be me fucking this place up because you're being a complete ass to me. You know what I mean? I'd like a bookcase of just stuff. Twelve of that, and then I can move some of this over. I should probably get some boots and stuff. There we go. And we got some artisanal weed. I think that's good. I think this will be good. I don't know, it was a weird experience, because it's just like, I've done nothing to harm you. Like, I've just asked you a question. And she was always in a bad mood. And it was always to someone else. And she would complain about, you know, the customer who came before me. She's like, oh, these people, they don't fucking understand anything. I know, they have a shitty job. And I'm fine with that, you know? Like, it's why I didn't really confront her on it. Because it's just like, you know, she's having a hard day, whatever. But she can also go fuck herself, honestly. I try not to make people have a bad day, you know? I legitimately try to have, like, a positive outlook on life, but sometimes people are assholes, you know what I mean? Close up shop so we can keep going. I don't think we need anything. I'd like a counter, just because we don't have one of those yet. Seems like we can't have a counter right where I want it. We gotta have it, like, here. She was kinda acting like Phyllis from Animal Crossing, I'm not gonna lie. So here's another example of something that was weird that happened to me recently. I had an experience, I should say, with a, there's the coffee shop on campus, right? There's a couple of coffee shops on campus. I think there are three, but there's only one near the art building, right? And that's the one I always go to. There's two different guys who work there, and there's a few new girls, but I don't know them yet, so I'm not going to speak on, like, what their behavior is like. The guys, are completely diametrically opposed. There's a very nice, very handsome Hispanic man. And he's great. He's always got a smile on his face. He has good taste in music. He keeps it turned low, though, just in case if you don't like it. And, you know, he's cool. He's very cool. And I like talking to him, you know? He makes an amazing mocha. Very good at making mochas. He doesn't need to, but he does a little art on, with the cream. But, I'm not gay, but I can say a guy is attractive. Fuck. Chad's acting like I'm weird for saying someone's attractive. What the fuck? Anyway. Just bros being bros. Anyway. He does a little art in the top, and he doesn't have to do it, you know? And it doesn't change my day any, because I always put a lid on it anyway, so I don't even get to see it. Right? But it's just an extra level of him giving a shit about the stuff, and it tastes amazing, it's always good quality, it's always sweet. I always give him a good tip. You know, when I can, I give him more than a 20% tip, you know? But, there's also a guy who works there, who... He never really... He never really seems to give a shit. He likes to listen to, lo-fi versions of Buddy Holly. He likes to crank his lo-fi versions of Buddy Holly. He has very poorly done pink hair. It's, like, mostly brown, but then there's also some pink. It looks very thin, very shaggy. Like, he just doesn't really care about his appearance. He has this sort of always damp look to him, and always like he just got out of the rain, like he's having a bad day, you know. Maybe that's why. He cannot make a cup of coffee to save his life. Honestly, like if I just asked for plain coffee, he'd probably fuck it up somehow. So. I don't tip him as good, you know? One day I tipped him, like, 10%, because the last time I think he made me a latte? He made a small latte rather than a large mocha, and it was when he finally did make the large mocha, which I had to be late to class for, it was fucking awful. Thank you for resubscribing, Dodoran. Don Duran, thank you for resubscribing. I've got to have your name right. Or else I look like an asshole. I don't know. I already look like an asshole for saying that I don't tip well if they don't give me what I asked for, but I'm gonna tip. Now, if it's something like, you know, Coke or whatever, like, where they don't have to do anything, like, I bought a sandwich, right? Bought a sandwich and asked for a glass of water. Didn't tip. Because the sandwich was already prepackaged. It came from the store that way. He didn't do anything. You know? And I was the easiest, like, person to deal with. Like, in and out. Didn't cause any fuss. Here's the sandwich. I got it from the cooler. Can I get a glass of water? Sure. Tap water is fine. Cool. How much do you pay for a large mug from a coffee shop in the USA? Depends. There's a place that we go to that's about $5, which is... I don't know what that is equivalent to wherever you're from, but it's, you know... It's a decent chunk of cash. Yeah. And then, that place is closer to about 3 to 4, somewhere in that region. It's $4.75. With a dollar tip, makes it $5.75, which is about 20%. It's a little bit more than 20%, but it's okay. Attractive Hispanic man, he deserves it. But damp hipster pink hair guy does not. I'm sorry, no. I believe firmly in tipping. Tipping really isn't a thing outside of the United States, and that's why a lot of people who aren't American don't get why our system's so fucked. Yeah, the guy should, you know, the company should be paying them enough where they don't have to depend on tips, but I know that that's not the case, and really, like, what do? Go to a place where they don't allow tips? No. Bullshit. Well, thanks for knocking my shit over, then. But I always go for, like, you know, mochas and stuff. You know, a little bit more than just a coffee. Because regular coffee you can screw up pretty easily. Mocha, you know, it's basically hot chocolate and espresso. You know? Cup of coffee, like, I'm gonna have to drown that shit in cream if you fuck it up. I got tipped working at a Randall's once, which is a grocery store. I carried someone's groceries out, and it was sleeting. It was almost snow. It was ice cold. It was awful. I didn't argue. We're not supposed to take tips, but, you know, I was just like, nah. It's better for the customer if I just take the money and we go, you know? A chai latte? I don't really like chai that much. I don't think the commands things works, but if you, jawbone shoulders. Let's see if anyone actually buys this shit. Wizard shoulders. Okay, that might work. Kind of keeping an eye on the shop from across the street. I can lightning bolt. What? Oh, that allows me to, like, manipulate and look at the thing. Oh. Fire potion. Fire resist potion. Cool. We're doing pretty good. We're selling quite a bit of stuff. And people are just coming in, buying stuff, throwing it on the floor. Because they are complete assholes. Throw a fire resist potion. No one wants this frost resist potion. So this quest is just not happening. It's a total scam, but, you know, they're not getting paid minimum wage because of it. And if there was a person who could actually change that so they were getting minimum wage and a living wage at that, then it would be just a tip based on, like, whether or not they did a good job. Yeah, maybe I wouldn't tip all the time, you know? Then it would just be like, you did an excellent job, you know? But they literally cannot make ends meet unless if I tip. It's a fucked up situation. And, you know, I just don't go to restaurants if I can't tip. That's just me. Like, if I can't tip, then I'm not gonna go to a place where I have to tip. Because I look like an asshole. And it's not right to not tip. That's a very American view, I think. But yeah. I haven't seen any research that proves the whole living wage will fuck up the economy thing. Things will get slightly more expensive, but not enough where it'll matter. It won't be an issue. All evidence I've seen has shown that it's not a problem, but... That's just me. It's one thing for... Coffee shop people get, like, $2.50 an hour. Plus, like... I think it's, like, $2.50 an hour. Plus tips. You don't get enough to live. You literally cannot live on 250. Don't you worry, Donald Trump will save America. That's a joke. But let's change off of the concept of politics, because people get offended when I talk politics. Let's get us that way. We got the portal. I feel like that's a good investment. Wait, no. How much would this be? God, it costs so much to get just basic things. What is this? 10% discount on every order you purchase. Make thieves steal less. I don't know if any of these are really worth it. I can get an adventurer for 400 points. I don't want the thing where I actually have to talk to them. I don't like talking to customers. I'm just gonna get so out we can charge them more money, I think. Get the gold as they enter thing, later. We need to get the rack where I can put this up, but we need to get some more stuff. So let's go get some more, let's get boots. I think someone just burped as they entered the room, which is gross. There we go. I need to get whatever that armor holder is. And then eventually start upgrading so that way people can buy this more expensive stuff. Because this is just too rich for their blood. Like, they literally can't. Like, they don't know how to buy this. Like, they don't know what this is. It's way too... Hey, Tipaz, thank you for resubscribing. Talking about economics really political? In America, it is. It's really nice that they have that really ramped up music and then it goes to this chill music. It's cool. What was that about an imprinted slot? That'd be cool if it just always... I don't know. Why is only half the counter usable? Because this half has to be used by robes. This half can be used by other stuff. Hello, Aurora. Aurora Bieber. Thanks. Didn't like the shoes, so you just decided to throw them. Yeah, it's fine. That's fine. People do that all the goddamn time. Go into fucking Walmart and just throw shit off the shelves because they don't like it. You know what I do when I don't like something in a store? I don't pick it up and throw it across the room like a fucking toddler. Goddamn children live in this town. Should jack up the prices more. They don't know what they're talking about. Jack up the price just now because of that bitch. I'm sorry. It's too expensive? Maybe you're just a bitch. Have you thought about that? They do? Oh. Well, shit. How much can I charge for? I've got skills now, where I can charge them 20%. So, I think that's fine. I think we're at a good level. Yeah, I can get a robot that kills them if they try and throw shit around or whatever. Or if they try and steal, more like. But, you know, maybe I can send them to kill people who just come in here and throw shit. Because it's just an extra thing I have to do in the day is cleaning up. We've got 10 points. We need, what's the cheapest thing we can buy? Can we switch out any of these? Because these are all awful. Like, I don't have the things for any of these. Looking for a what? What were you looking for? Do you want this stealth chest? I don't like this item. Okay, fine. Their faces are really fucked. The women's faces, they're really messed up looking. We're in the building phase. The day has ended. I think we have one of every type of holding, at least. In some cases more. So now we can sell the stealth chest. Maybe the leather chest. I mean, I'm not talking about, like, YouTubers being assholes and throwing stuff on the ground. I mean, like, just normal, reputably normal-esque people. You know what I mean? They don't actually have to be normal people, but, like, people who you would assume have been normal at one point in their lives. Not like YouTubers. Wouldn't consider YouTubers normal. Okay. I'm definitely in that number of people who are just fucked up. Enchanted robe. There you go. Wizard. There you go. I'm gonna get some more weed. Just plant it. Right? So we got 1, 2, 3 bookshelves, right? So 3 times 12 is 36, right? Can I afford 36 weed? No. There's no way in hell. But it's close. $27. That's pretty good. That's a lot of weed. I'm gonna buy that. We're gonna start the day. Alright, what's up, everyone? Mohawk helm? Sure, fuck it. We'll put that out. I don't think anyone wants this, but we'll go ahead and do it anyway. Gotta do the early morning trash bin run. You know what I like? I don't know if there's a name for this, but going into a building before or after it's been closed that's normally inhabited with a lot of people. Like, being in a school building, right? But after it's all closed down for the day. Like, there's something very nice about that to me. Maybe it's just because I'm antisocial. I don't know. But just being able to walk the halls and explore and not be, like, told, don't go in there. Be like, I'm gonna go where the fuck I want. Left click to imprint an item on your hand. It pops up with that for a second, and then it doesn't. That's 3 beds worth of weed. I call that trespassing. Am I depressed? No. Fuck, I'm having a really good day. What should you expect? Well, currently we're growing weed because we need more weed. That's one thing you can expect. Abandoned buildings are kind of fun to explore. When I used to do ghost hunting, that was something we would get to do. We'd get to go in buildings that we weren't supposed to go into. It was cool. Left click to imprint the item in your hand on the spot. Currently imprinting any item. I don't understand what that would do. I don't understand what that means. So it's like, anytime I need... Is that for the bot docs? Ghost hunting was fun. It was a worthwhile use of my time. Go to Chernobyl. I've got other things that I would do. Like, not get killed. Yeah, there used to be a guy who came by stream and he used to be really into urban exploring. I don't understand why I would imprint things.
Jumping is for jokers.
Yeah, but so is trying to place things in this game at times. Swear to God, did you just... Don't throw shit. Yeah, he explained in printing. So why would I reserve a slot to that? What good is that? So I know what I'm out of? I don't have enough things. Another belt. Dragon bone belts, which I won't fucking buy. You gotta keep an eye on them, because they will try and jack me. I'm gonna go get some more coffee. I'm gonna run over there and then get coffee. Has anyone here ever wanted to make their own superhero? Yeah, I think everyone has at one point, right? See, they say they want enchanted robes. They say on the wall that they want enchanted robes sometimes. Like right now, what do they want? Fucking plate helm, mana potions. Alright, we can get mana potions. Fuck it. We'll have mana potions today. We'll buy 238 gold worth of mana potions. And you know what? They'll sell, because that's actually a legitimate choice, and I just am complaining about shit that doesn't matter. We're gonna have to take those off the shelves. They're just not selling. It's just not happening. It's not happening. There we go. Should probably clean a shelf off. Oh wait, it's not just that. Let's go and get a... We'll fill it up again when, we got this. Okay. Is there any way to imprint just any item? Or do we have to, like... I don't know. I don't get imprinting. I feel like I'm being dumb, though. I think it's for those machines, because you can get the bots to go and do certain things. And, that's one of the things you can do. It's just go and... Control or Alt to unimprint. Alright, come into my shop, buy my shit, and get out. Thank you. See? That's how it's done. No throwing shit around, no temper tantrums, no bullshit. You know? It's fine. Dick Rednose, the mage. Another mana potion for you. Should I buy more mana potions? I think once I run out, I'll buy more. Excuse me, bitch? What do you want? Going to check out weed. Offer inventory item. Weed. Asshole. She's like, I don't want that weed! How about this weed? Okay.
Stay on the ground, young man.
No. Hey, what do you want? Going to check out leather chest? Well, let me tell you about this leather chest you just dropped on the fucking ground, asshat. How about this? Yeah, and then you bought it! Fucker! So if I just offer it to them once they throw it on the ground, then it's fine. They'll take the trash things. Check the weed? Oh fuck, did I leave some back there? No, wait, fuck you. Has anyone ever wanted to make their own comic book? Oh, that's a little bit more work than I'm willing to do. I've got to do one for one of my classes. We're doing in the style of different artists, and the artist that I'm doing is Raymond Pettibon. We have to guess what he'll be doing in like 2 years or so. In 2018, so yeah, 2 years. And I'm going to guess that he's going to start making comics, because that seems like something he would do. He's the guy who did the, Black Flag logo and a bunch of stuff like that. I just don't have the dedication to make a comic. I used to work in the comic department at UT. You're looking for a wild growth potion. Well, I don't know. It's more work than I can deal with, you know? It's a lot of work. It's a lot of, time. Porn comics. Yep, that's good. Just, they'll print that in the paper. The school that I go to right now tried to do comics, like, for 1 week, and it just went badly. Like, no one read it, and the shit they put in was awful. I'm gonna go get some more coffee. Be right back. As someone who does YouTube and stuff, I gotta tell you, if you're gonna do anything creative, I think the best way to do it to keep from having stress is to, me just running in the background there. Come back here, you asshat! Yeah, if I just offer it to them, they're fine. Oh, it's because I'm selling it for a little bit more. Let me bring down the price. Can I jack up the price for selling things to people? So anyway, if you're doing anything creative, my recommendation would be to just be ready. Like, have some extra stuff, ready to go before you start. And that way, if you have an off day, if you get sick or whatever, you don't have to worry about it as much. Like, you have that extra day's worth of work done. And then you're fine. Everyone's going inside now. It's almost the witching hour where everyone gets mugged. I think you basically have to use Patreon in America to do a comic. I don't know. I would never try and do it myself. It's way too much work. And I'm not good enough at writing stories. So it's like, even if I could get the art aesthetic the way I wanted it, I couldn't write a good enough story. Like, really, it doesn't seem like it would be that hard, but having done it before, like, it's just, it's so much work. Being able to keep up with a plot throughout weeks and weeks and weeks, and make it interesting still. And make each new edition interesting. Make a Vine Sauce comic? No. Someone else can do that. I don't have the dedication to do it, you know? And I'm not down for the, like, oh, I'll write it if you do the art. Because the people who do that aren't dedicated enough to, like, actually write it. And then they just fuck me over. I don't know. We went to Half Price Books the other day, me and Tilda. And she had never heard of, what was it? Mega Tokyo. Like, that was intense. So I had to explain what this bullshit comic was. For those of you that don't know, Mega Tokyo was this weird creation. It's like a webcomic created by an American that was about a guy going to Japan and getting stuck there. And it was a really weird thing. Very 90s. Very, you know, Elite Hacksaws, I think, was a serious line in it. You might want to check it. It's weird. It's very much a sign of its time. But yeah. So, I mean, if you're gonna start doing a webcomic or something, get like 20 pages or 20 days worth of stuff in. And that way, or at least a few weeks worth in. Just so that way, when you have slip-ups, and then just keep producing at that rate. So that way, if you, you know, have a bad day or whatever, you never have an off thing. I've been so much happier having stuff had done in advance from spring break. The Natalan thing I filmed, I think this week, yeah. But just knowing that, like, it was okay. Like, I had some time to breathe and I didn't have to stress as much. You know, I had a lot of creative influence and I had time to film it, so I did. And then, that way I had content for days. Buffers are super important, is what I'm trying to say. Came to buy the weed. The hard-to-get-to weed. She was dedicated.
Stay on the ground, young man.
There you go. And I would imagine comics are the same way. So just having that buffer. And you need to have vacations, because you're gonna have burnout if you don't. Regardless of what a creative thing you do. I don't know. I encourage everyone to do something creative. We spend too much time, like, consuming media and not enough making and, doing things. You know what I mean? And that really causes you to not, tell you to go work on your comic. Go work on your comic. Can I have permission to link the cover of Mega Tokyo? Sure. Someone, if you don't mind, Mafa, giving him permission so he can link it. As a kid, my friends were totally into it, and I couldn't get too far into it. It just really wasn't, my thing. I have a feeling that I would write a too edgy, for me thing. I thought about doing one based on the concept albums of King Diamond, where I would just go through and I would draw it, but I started, but I just didn't get very far. So I got as far as, like, the intro of Abigail. Let me look at this. Yeah. Wow, yeah. Mega Tokyo, there it is for you. I'm actually going to show that on stream real quick, just that way people can see. Let's see. Borrow this. Properties. Select region. There you go. Mega Tokyo. That's the one that we were talking about. The art did get better over time. It got a lot better, but it was still pretty shit. This is first edition Mega Tokyo. Anyway, back to the game. Just because we were talking about it. King Diamond is like my favorite singer. Did that comic ever go anywhere? It went amazingly far. He lived off of it for a while. I don't know what happened to it. I think he just stopped working on it. That's interesting. Just gonna keep doing that, I guess. So we got 13 points. I don't think there's anything we can spend 13 points worth of, K on. Moral guide, if I had 15. Nothing really. I pretty much have everything that's cheap. This is 40. That's 55. That's 50. Mages want weed tomorrow. Holy fuck. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. Here's what we gotta do, okay? First step. Where is it? Bookcase. I need a bookcase. There you go. I can't do this the way I want to. That's unfortunate. Time to jack up the price on weed for reals. That should be enough for today, right? Now, that's 12, 36 minus 6, because I just had 6, We need 30 more. There's no way we can buy that much, but we will buy as much as possible. I was going to stop there, but you know what? It's weed day. We got to go sell weed. We got to. We'll buy 14 because that's the most we can buy. I think I might start carrying some of this shit around on me. Like, maybe someone wants some of this. I don't know. I honestly don't. The best way to get more points actually is to do this stuff, but people don't have we don't have the items for this. Nobody will buy them. Stream's gonna end after this day. After this day, it'll end. I hate the weed on this desk. Like, it's so hard to get to. Like, this area is just really hard to get to, and I don't know why that is, but yeah. Okay, we got one bookshelf filled out. We'll get a couple more. If you grow it, they will come. Come. I'm holding down right-click until it actually gets into the right trigger location for it to do it. Never skip weed day. Play what he linked during the day. I'm trying not to do any copyrighted music, if that's alright. Snoop. I'm gonna go open the day, and by the time I get back, I bet that stuff is ready to go. No one wants to buy any of these hats, by the way. Have you noticed? Purple weed exists? Yeah, it's good. I shouldn't encourage weed usage, should I? Should be a responsible adult that doesn't encourage people to smoke weed. But you know what I am? An irresponsible little shit. So, smoke weed every day. You never know, it gets, flagged on YouTube, honestly. It's such a dumb system. Really is, like, the worst. Okay, these people, they don't want that shit. I don't think it's copyrighted. It most definitely is. I mean, I'm not trying to do anything fancy. I'm just trying to... Alright. There we go. That's fine, right? Looks a little bit scarce. We'll buy more when we can. Come into my store, sir. Lloyd Rednose? Well, I'll be happy to tell you that we're having a sale on weed. Buy one. I shove one up your ass. Yeah. Wants it when I shove it up his ass, but, you know, if we just put it on the shelf, he's like, this is disgusting garbage. Was that a sombrero in my hand? Unfortunately, no. It was not. We do not have sombrero technology just yet, but we will. We're working on it. Sombrero technology is high up on our list of things. I think we need to get the portal next. I think that should be our next thing. Okay. We're gonna have to start getting a back stock of weed. Can we get another one? No. It's too expensive. You're teaching your patrons that if they throw shit on the ground, you'll give it to them for cheaper. Well, not sure what to do about that. I mean, you walked around the counter that had... Whatever. How much do I need for the teleportation one? I think it's 20, right? 20k? I get some for 25, shit. Okay. There we go. This goes outside in the back. We gotta buy more weed. By the time we get done planting this, we can come back out, sell it, and we'll be good. Sombrero hat is hat hat. I guess that is a hat hat, but... Should also get the one where they don't try and steal as much, too. That would be important. grow faster. Weed, I love you. Come to me. Grow strong. Grow quickly. Be the best Kush that I've ever seen in my life. Thank you. All right, let's go. Back into the shop. No one looks like they tried to steal anything, so we're good. We got weed. We got money, we got rhymes. We got weed, we got time. If you leave dead bodies outside your shop, it actually just freaks out normal patrons, which is fair enough.
Hello, weed. We could have a good time, you and me. Just a bowl of weed. Bowl of Fruit Loops. We forget about the Fruit Loops because the weed is so strong. We got Judge Judy on. We just enjoy our time with the weed and the Fruit Loops. Judge Judy, she's freaking out. We're not. We don't lace our weed with shit. We have the nicest, kindest weed.
There we go. Alright, let's go. Run out the door, get some weed on the shelf. Bam. Bam, bam. Bam, bam. More chewing? I don't have anything to chew on. I think I ate all of the food in the house. Alright, we're buying more weed. People are where did Judge Judy come from? So one time I got really, let's just say I went over to a friend's house. And, we are going to enjoy some lettuce that he had. Yes? Anyway, lettuce does things to your mind. Let's just say. We'll call it lettuce for now, right? We're going to have a salad. We're going to have some salad. And, he ended up having to go to work. So I was like, alright, fine. He drove me to his apartment. So I was kind of stuck there. Waiting for him to, leave. Or to come back from work. But, did you just throw that? Anyway. I ended up, having some of the salad, and, I started thinking, right? I started thinking about this place. Started thinking about Batman, right? Batman has a bat cave, right? He's got the, you know, like the classic 1960s or whatever Batman? 1970s. Where it's played by, what is that actor's name? It's like the groovy Batman? Anyway, in that version of Batman, they've got this, like, secret bust that when you pull down the head you can like press a button and there's a secret like area like the Batcave from that. So I'm sitting there eating salad and I'm thinking to myself, what if my friend has I don't know, what if he doesn't know that he's got a secret Batcave? Like, how would you know if you had a secret Batcave? Unless if you installed it, right? What if the previous owners of this apartment, you know, they installed a secret Batcave, and then they didn't tell the apartment complex about it? He would never... Adam West, there you go. He didn't, you know that there was this secret Batcave. Where the fuck would you put a secret Batcave, right? So I'm thinking to myself as I'm eating salad, I'm like, wow, I should go and get... I should go find his secret Batcave, because it's going to be cool, right? So I'm like, alright, where is this Batcave going to be, you know? It's got to be something that was in this apartment prior to him moving in, right? So I'm thinking, if I were going to install a Batcave, I would put it so that way it was one of the bricks in the fireplace, right? And it's going to be some Hogwarts shit, where you got to press the right bricks in order to like get to the Batcave. So I was watching Judge Judy while this was happening, and I just turn off the TV, or at least I stop paying attention to it, I'm not sure. And I just started pushing all the bricks, trying to figure out what the combination was. Because, I mean, if it was like a multi-brick combination, then I don't know. And I got to figure out where the first brick was. So. So, that is my salad eating story. See, it could have been like an iPhone lock, where like if you try too many times, it totally fucks up your ability to like actually unlock it, you know? And that was my worry. But that was my lettuce eating story. It's like the Konami code with the bricks. He came back and I was still pushing the bricks around. Trying to figure out how to get into the Batcave. I'm gonna buy more weed. Did I find the Batcave? No. Related note, so his fireplace was, he lived on the second floor. And the fireplace was on the outside wall. So that meant that if there was a secret door, it would have opened directly into the parking lot. Yes, exactly, Varanaxis. Or however you pronounce your name. Yeah, that's what I did. I spent an evening of my life, it seemed like hours, just trying to figure out where his Batcave was. So, that's why I always think of Judge Judy when I think about lettuce. I want to witness Rev Logic live. Well, you can either do that right now, because I'm live on Twitch, or you can always come and see me at Too Many Games. What kind of apartment has a fireplace? There are a few here that do. Usually you have to pay a little bit more. That was what the best part was, that like, when I like, sobered up, I guess? I realized that it would be impossible for there to actually be a Batcave there. Like, there would be nowhere for that Batcave to go. It just wouldn't work. When is Too Many Games? I believe it's June 20-something. It's near the end of June. I need to double-check that, because I don't remember off the top of my head. I probably should. I mean, for a weed day, this has been a very calm day. I just told a story about how I ate lettuce. Wasn't about smoking weed. Not that the statute of limitations would have affected me at this point, if I was. Someone came in here and threw that shit on the floor. It's really unfortunate. Did I get into the Overwatch open beta weekend? I didn't actually try, so no. Overwatch is all fucked. Did I just rot out all the weed? Okay, I got this. Okay. It's still fine. It almost wasn't. We need to get Dicky back. Yeah, but he's got 400k in order to even hire Dicky. Dicky is expensive. They can arrest you for stuff that you... I guess they can't arrest you for stuff that you allegedly did in the past. They have to have some proof. And I guess I could just be lying. I mean, I could be lying. Maybe I've never eaten lettuce, you know? Right? Maybe I'm just lying to you guys. Let's assume that I am, so that way I can tell more stories about eating lettuce. I wonder if there's a way I can get more K quickly. You're a cop, oh shit. This one gives us more appeal. Is lettuce banned in Texas? No, weed is. Mark items up to 150%. Should I wait to get the entry fee one? Or should I get this? This gives me extra money on every single one that I sell. I mean, today was a pretty good day as far as money goes. I sold some, and I got a lot of K, so I must have been doing a lot of sales. I was kind of not paying attention anymore. Texas banning salad would explain a lot of things, like our obesity rate. Get some gold as the entry. Yeah, I kind of think I want that. I wasn't hugging fireplaces, I was pressing bricks, because there's a bat cave. Swear to God, there could have been a bat cave there. I mean, how would you know? I remember hearing about this. See, this is part of what sparked it. I remember reading the story about this guy, this girl. She was the youngest daughter in this family, right? And there were rats in her walls, right? And it was always freaking her out. So they went out to, I forget what happened, but eventually they found out that they didn't have rats. They apparently actually just had, like, a secret room in their house they didn't know about. And it was, the entrance was in her room. And apparently there had just been, like, this homeless dude. I guess he's not homeless if he lives secretly in your house. Just living in the house for, like, years. Because there was, like, this secret loft that they didn't know existed. Because, you know, again, secret bat cave. And I think that may have been what got me started. Thinking about, like, you know, the Adam West Batman and stuff like that. It's a creepy story. Anyway, I think that's the end of the day. Or soon to be the end of the day. Better run, bitch. I mean, he's not homeless if he lives in your house, is he? He's just secretly living in your house. Can I put these, like, in the back room so I can, like, not hate their aesthetic? I mean, like, I can't put them where I'd want to. Oh, that would be cool. I'd be down with that. Or what about, this shit? He's not... I mean, it's not his home, but who cares? He's got a home. Yeah, the term is squatter, I guess, but, you know. He lived somewhere. He had a residence, so he's not homeless, right? Anyway, we're gonna go and save up and then quit out. I'm gonna check the art to make sure that there's not any art, but yeah, let us see. I know there's at least one piece of art, and I definitely want to show it because it's something that Volcanic Fires made. There's I kind of want to like discuss maybe something along those design for a shirt. So I want to see what you guys think. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna look at this piece by Volcanic Fires and a bunch of other people. Then who did the rest of this art? Moon Man Max. Okay. And then there's sorry, you guys can't see the art yet. Should probably show you. Let me show you this one from Volcanic Fires first. That's my art. Properties. This region. There we go. Okay. This one is by Volcanic Fires. And it is huge. Let me fit it to screen region. I was thinking about something along these lines for a shirt. It's the Rev gas mask, but very mechanical. They've been doing a lot of this kind of thing, because I think We had a bit of a miscommunication when it came to what we were going to do. Would you guys like something like this as a shirt? People seem to be liking it. It's a good piece of art. They've done a lot of different iterations of this kind of thing. And, I think it's pretty fucking sweet. You started a drawing, but you haven't finished. I'll take my time, and if you don't get it done today, I'll show it tomorrow if you post it on the board. Just make sure you tag me in it. Maybe with a little less of the stuff around the outside, just because it's really hard to tell where the mask begins, but this is pretty fucking cool. Alright, cool. Chat likes it. That's one design we could do. Along with some of the stuff that we talked about for emotes, like shopkeep stuff, senpai. We already did one that's senpai related, and I love that shirt. It's too bad I didn't buy one. I had to kind of decide which one I wanted, or else I would have not made any money by buying all of them. Here's one, and I need to remember who did this. Moonman Max. There you go. It's Vinny, Yol, and myself as sort of Mario characters. I look a little bit like those guys that shoot bullets. You know what I mean? I think it's the different versions. This is like Super Mario 1, 2, and then maybe Worlds? No, this is 3. I forget. But yeah, I get the top hat when I level up. Vinny gets a hat, and Yol's hair gets let down. Then we got this one from C. Is Rev Tilda? How dare you? Tilda is my girlfriend. Did I really say it like that? That seems like something I would do. And then we've got this last one by Titos2K. I know a handsome man when I see one. Yeah. It's kind of a little bit like that, actually. He's a Sniffit from Mario 2. There you go. That's what I'm talking about. I think that's right. But yeah, very good art today. I think I've shown all the rest of this. I want to make sure that I didn't miss anything. But good quality stuff. You said it more like, Tilda is my girlfriend, right? What? Really? Okay. You can always check out the art on the Boru. A lot of times, I try and convince people to put, like, information about, like, you know, where they can go and get stuff. I think if you just go, like, and search Volcanic Fires on Tumblr, you could find them, and probably with the rest of these guys as well. C does a good job of making sure that the at in, they have their Twitter handle, at C Donovan. I would recommend that to the guy that's still working on his art, unless if it totally messes up the aesthetic, in which case I would put it in the box below. So that way, if people want to commission you, or if you want to do commissions, they can talk to you. It's a decent way of advertising yourself. A few hundred people watch it live, then a few hundred people watch it on after hours. Might as well, right? Might as well. Where would I submit art? You can always go to vinesauce.com, then you go up to the community tab, and then there's the Boru. You go onto the Boru, and you do it there. You make sure you want to tag me as the streamer, and that way it pops up when I look for it. And there you go. Anyway, I am going to go sleep, maybe. I don't know. I'm going to go relax. I don't think there's an art. Is there one for Boru? There should be. I should make one for Boru. Yeah, there you go. Boru works. There's the link. Cool. You can always do !Boru. Anyway, I'm going to go for now. Thank you guys so much for watching. You guys are amazing. It's going to be good getting back into streaming. Because of the gallery show, I just haven't had the time, and I'm just ultra psyched about this, because, you know, I think I needed a little bit of a break from streaming, and it helped out my mood, it helped me come up with more ideas. Doing a different sort of creative task, and then coming to this sort of creative task was good for me. Does that make sense? Certain type of creativity that I don't get to show off, when I'm doing art, that can only be shown off through more performative stuff, like streaming. And vice versa. And so it's good to switch between the two because it gets me thinking about stuff in a different way. So I think I've got some good stuff coming up, and you guys will want to see that. But that'll be Saturdays and Sundays for sure, maybe Fridays. When the stream ends, if you go and look at the actual in like stream is over screen, you'll be able to see that. But anyway, thank you guys. I will see you guys later. Bye.